Canadian cuisine varies widely depending on the regions of the nation. The three earliest cuisines of Canada have First Nations, English, Scottish and French roots, with the traditional cuisine of English Canada closely related to British and Scottish cuisines, while the traditional cuisine of French Canada has evolved from French cuisine and the winter provisions of fur traders. With subsequent waves of immigration in the 19th and 20th century from Central, Southern, and Eastern Europe, South Asia, East Asia, and the Caribbean, the regional cuisines were subsequently augmented. Definitions: although certain dishes may be identified as Canadian due to the ingredients used or the origin of its inception, an overarching style of Canadian cuisine is more difficult to define. Some Canadians, such as the former Canadian Prime Minister Joe Clark, believe that Canadian cuisine is a collage of dishes from the cuisines of other cultures. Clark himself has been paraphrased to have noted, "Canada has a cuisine of cuisines. Not a stewpot, but a smorgasbord." Some have sought to define Canadian cuisine along the line of how Claus Meyer defined Nordic cuisine in his Manifesto for the New Nordic Kitchen. Namely that dishes in Canadian cuisine should reflect Canadian seasons, that they should use locally sourced ingredients that thrive in the Canadian climate, and that they are combined with good taste and health in mind. Others believe that Canadian cuisine is still in the process of being defined from the cuisines of the numerous cultures that have influenced it, and that being a culture of many cultures, Canada and its cuisine is less about a particular dish but rather how the ingredients are combined. Cultural contributions. Canadian food has been shaped and impacted by continual waves of immigration, with the types of foods and from different regions and periods of Canada reflecting this immigration. Aboriginal peoples: the traditional Aboriginal cuisine of Canada was based on a mixture of wild game, foraged foods, and farmed agricultural products. Each region of Canada with its own First Nations and Inuit people used their local resources and own food preparation techniques for their cuisines. Maple syrup was first collected and used by Aboriginal people of eastern Canada and northeastern U.S. Canada is the world's largest producer of maple syrup. The origins of maple syrup production are not clear, though the first syrups were made by repeatedly freezing the collected maple sap and removing the ice to concentrate the sugar in the remaining sap. Maple syrup is one of the most commonly consumed Canadian foods of Aboriginal origins. In most of the Canadian West Coast and Pacific Northwest, Pacific salmon was an important food resource to the First Nations peoples, along with certain marine mammals. Salmon were consumed fresh when spawning or smoke-dry to create a jerky-like food that can be stored year-round. The latter food is commonly known and sold as salmon jerky. Whipped sobori, known as ksawasam in the interior Salish languages of British Columbia, is consumed similarly to ice cream or as a cranberry cocktail-like drink. It is known for being a kidney tonic, which are called agutak in Arctic Canada. In the Arctic, Inuit traditionally survived on a diet consisting of land and marine mammals, fish, and foraged plant products. Meats were consumed fresh but also often prepared, cached, and allowed to ferment it into igunak or kuviak. These fermented meats have the consistency and smell of certain soft-aged cheeses. Snacks such as McDuke, which consist of whale skin and blubber, is eaten plain, though sometimes dipped in soy sauce. Chunks of McDuke are sliced with a nyula prior to or during consumption. Fish are eaten boiled, fried, and prior to today's settlements, often in dried forms. The so-called Eskimo potato, and other mouse foods are some of the plants consumed in the Arctic. Foods such as bannock, popular with First Nations and Inuit, reflect the historic exchange of these cultures with Scottish fur traders, who brought with them new ingredients and foods. Common contemporary consumption of bannock, powdered milk, and bologna by Aboriginal Canadians reflects the legacy of Canadian colonialism in the prohibition of hunting and fishing, and the institutional food rations provided to Indian reserves. Due to similarities in treatment under colonialism, many Native American communities throughout the continent consume similar food items with some emphasis on local ingredients. Europeans, settlers and traders from the British Isles account for the culinary influences of early English Canada in the Maritimes and southern Ontario, while French settlers account for the cuisine of southern Quebec, northern Ontario, and New Brunswick. Southwestern regions of Ontario have strong Dutch and Scandinavian influences. In Canada's prairie provinces, which saw massive immigration from Eastern and Northern Europe in the pre-WW1 era, Ukrainian, German, and Polish cuisines are strong culinary influences. Also noteworthy in some areas of the British Columbia interior and the prairies is the cuisine of the Doukhobors, Russian-descended vegetarians. The Waterloo, Ontario, region in the southern portion of the province of Manitoba have traditions of Mennonite and Germanic cookery. The cuisines of Newfoundland and the Maritime provinces derive mainly from British and Irish cooking, with a preference for salt-cured fish, beef, and pork. Ontario, Manitoba and British Columbia also maintain strong British cuisine traditions. Jewish immigrants to Canada during the late 1800s played a significant culinary role within Canada, chiefly renowned for Montreal-style bagels and Montreal-style smoked meat. A regional variation of both emerged within Winnipeg, Manitoba's Jewish community, which also derived Winnipeg-style cheesecake from New York recipes. Winnipeg has given birth to numerous other unique dishes, such as the shmoo-torti and co-op-style rye bread and cream cheese. East Asian, much of what are considered Chinese dishes in Canada are more likely to be Canadian or North American inventions, with the Chinese restaurants of each region tailoring their traditional cuisine to local tastes. This Canadian Chinese cuisine is widespread across the country, with great variation from place to place. The Chinese buffet, although found in the United States and other parts of Canada, had its origins in early Garstown, Vancouver, c. 1870. This serving setup came out of the practice of the many Scandinavians working in the woods and mills around the shantytown, getting the Chinese cook to put out a steam table on a sideboard, so they could load up, and leave room on the dining table. National food, common contenders as the Canadian national food include, poutine, butter tarts, macaroni and cheese. According to an informal survey by the Globe and Mail conducted through Facebook from collected comment, users considered the following to be the Canadian national dish, with maple syrup likely above all the other foods if it was considered: poutine, Montreal-style bagels, salmon jerky, pierogi, ketchup chips, Nova Scotian dorma, California roll. In another survey from the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation in the summer of 2012, maple syrup, poutine, Nanaimo bars, smoked salmon, and butter tarts, regional, while many ingredients are commonly found. Throughout Canada, each region with its own history and local population has unique ingredients, which are used to define unique dishes. Wild game of all sorts is still hunted and eaten by many Canadians, though not commonly in urban centres. Venison, from white-tailed deer, moose, elk or caribou, is eaten across the country and is considered quite important to many First Nations cultures. Seal meat is eaten, particularly in the Canadian North, the Maritimes, and Newfoundland and Labrador. Wild fowl like ducks and geese, grouse and ptarmigan are also regularly hunted. Other animals like bear and beaver may be eaten by dedicated hunters or indigenous people, but are not generally consumed by much of the population. West Coast salmon varieties include Sockie, Coho, Taka, Chinook or King, and Pink. Wild chanterelle, pine, morel, lobster, puffball, and other mushrooms are commonly consumed. Canada produces good cheeses, many successful beers and is known for its excellent ice wines and ice ciders. Gooseberries, salmonberries, pearberries, cranberries and strawberries and gathered from wild or grown. Some Canadian foods, savory foods, although there are considerable overlaps between Canadian food and the rest of the cuisine in North America, many unique dishes are found and available only in the country. Some are more commonly eaten than others. Sweets. Pets de Zanas, a Euro pastry dough wrapped around a brown sugar and butter filling, matrimonial cake and pork pies, maple syrup, especially tire da copyright rabel sur la neige or maple toffee, also as flavoring, for example in maple leaf cream cookies, jam busters, apple pie, various black licorices, bumbleberry pie, Nanaimo bars a Euro most common in British Columbia, butter tarts a Euro said to be invented in eastern Ontario around 1915. The main ingredients for the filling includes butter, sugar and eggs, but raisins and pecans are often added for additional flavor. Beaver tails, also known as elephant ears, moose antlers or whale tails, sugar pie, Persianza Euro, somewhat like a cross between a large cinnamon bun and a donut, topped with strawberry icing, unique to Thunder Bay, Ontario. Suka a la Crame Euro Quay Copyright Bar Copyright Qua Sweet Milk Squares. Nougat Bricot, a Quay Copyright Bar Copyright Qua Preserve consisting of apricots, almonds, and pistachios. Candy Apple Euro, also known by the British term toffee apple, candied apples are far more popular than in the United States, where the caramel apple is common. Moose Hunters. Figgy Duff a Euro, a pudding from Newfoundland. Flat Papaya Euro, a custard pie popular in Western Canada. Tiger Tail Ice Cream, the once omnipresent black licorice and orange flavor ice cream popular throughout Canada. Grandpa Res, dough dumplings deep fried in maple syrup, commercially prepared food and beverages. Chocolate bars, Coffee Crisp, Mr. Big, Caramilk, Big Turk, Cherry Blossom, Crunchy, Crispy Crunch, Aero, Other Candy, Glacette Pieces, Bridge Mixture, Kraft Dinner, Canadian Pizza. The recipe is also known internationally by this name. Shreedy Cereal, Cow's Ice Cream, Red River Cereal, Ketchup, Salt and Vinegar, Dill Pickle, and All Dressed Flavored Potato Chips, Nabob Coffee, Tim Hortons, Second Cup Coffee, Hawkins Cheeses, Canada Dry Ginger Ale, Spruce Beer from Quebec, Loganberry from Crystal Beach, Ontario, Bagged Milk, Ready to Eat Soups, Red Rose Tea, Ringolos and Humpty Dumpty Party Mix, Alcohol. Straight, Canadian Beer, Canadian Whiskey, Rye Whiskey, Yukon Jack, a Canadian whiskey-based liqueur similar to the U.S. drink Southern Comfort, Canadian wine, ice cider, Newfoundland Screech, mixes, maple liqueur, sold bottled as Sortilege. This drink combines Canadian whiskey and maple syrup, Caribou, a mix of red wine, maple syrup, and Canadian whiskey. Consumed during winter festivals in Quebec. The Caesar, originally called the Bloody Caesar, is a cocktail made from vodka, Clamato juice, Worcestershire sauce, Tabasco sauce, in a salt-rimmed glass, and garnished with a stalk of celery, or more adventurously with a spoonful of horseradish, or a shot of beef bourguignon. The Caesar was invented in 1969 in Calgary, Alberta, by bartender Walter Chell to mark the opening of a new restaurant, Marco's. Street food. While most major cities in Canada offer a variety of street food, regional specialities are notable. While poutine is available in most of the country, it is far more common in Quebec. Similarly, hot dog stands can be found across Canada, but are far more common in Ontario than in Vancouver or Victoria. Montreal offers a number of specialities including shish chalk, the Montreal hot dog, and dollar falafels. Although falafel is widespread in Vancouver, pizza slices are much more popular. Vancouver also has many sushi establishments. Shawarma is quite prevalent in Ottawa and Windsor, while Halifax offers its own unique version of the Dar Paragraph Nair kebab called the Dorma, which features a distinctive sauce made from condensed milk, sugar, garlic and vinegar. Ice cream trucks can be seen nationwide during the summer months. Recently, the City of Toronto has encouraged street vendors from around the world to sell their food. Meal formats: Chinese smorgasbord, lumberjack's breakfast, also known as logger's breakfast, also known as the lumbia gargantuan breakfast of 3+ eggs. Rations of ham, bacon and sausages. Plus several large pancakes. Invented by hotelier J. Houston c. 1870, at his Granville Hotel on Water Street in Old Pre-Railway Garstown, Vancouver, in response to requests from his clientele for a better feed at the start of a long, hard day of work. See also. References. Further reading: Driver, Elizabeth, Culinary Landmarks, A Bibliography of Canadian Cookbooks, 1825 a Euro 1949, University of Toronto Press, ISBN 978-0-8020-4790-8. External links. CBC Digital Archives. A Euromy Canada includes Tour Cherie, Canadian Packaged Food Image Gallery.